Hi everyone. I'm Gary.
I'm Ronnie.
We are GaRon Stitchery.
The house of GaRon something bad.
Yay.
Yes, I memorized that good.
We've been doing pretty good. Now watch it. We jinxed it for next time. Okay. So if you're new or if you haven't watched many of our videos, we are a Flosstube channel about cross stitch. We show what we stitch because we are cross stitchers ourselves. And we currently own an online cross stitch shop that you can buy from us on the website.
For now.
We are opening up an LNS in the future, but we'll still keep the online shop as well. So we'll give you more information when that date comes.
In the end of the video, we posted a picture of the progress in the building.
Yes.
The outside.
Yeah.
The Tuesday, they will start inside.
Yes. Finally. Yeah. All right.
If you are new, mm-hmm. welcome. It is your first time. Thank you for joining us.
Yep.
We have the... Whoa, I forgot what I'm going to say. Sorry, guys. But I'm thinking is... we have any shout-outs?
Yes, we have. Well, we have a shout-out that someone emailed us about last week, and I didn't... It was after we did the video.
Oh, yes.
Yeah. So one of our viewers sent us an email that they were watching Teresa Kogut's Flosstube, mm-hmm. and one of our Stitching in the Wild ladies that went to Stitching in the Wild sent Teresa a picture and an email about the exclusive chart that she designed for us, Sunshine and Blooms, and Teresa showed it, and she showed her the stitcher's modification where she put the alphabet on the bottom instead of the words.
Mm-hmm.
And Teresa stated that she will be releasing that pattern sometime in 2024 with the option of doing the verb or the alphabet, which mm-hmm. both look gorgeous.
Yes.
So we want to thank the lady who sent us the email. We want to thank our Stitching in a Wild lady who sent in the information to Teresa, and we want to thank Teresa because it was really nice to have.
It's a beautiful chain.
Yeah, it's all connected. You know, it's 5 degrees over. Everybody's all connected.
Yeah.
So thank you, everyone.
Thank you very much.
Okay, and we have. I wanted to talk about fast shipping before we get into everything.
Okay.
Because fast shipping is very important to us. And what we control in fast shipping is once you send in your order, we pick it, pack it, process it, print the label, pack it, so the post office can pick it up. That's where we control the fast shipping. And then we hand it off as a relay race, a baton to the postal system, and they finish the race for us.
Yeah.
So we are only as good as the chain in the link of how many postal distribution centers your order has to go through, or if you're in a major city or a minor or smaller city.
And thank you to our post office in Ozark, Alabama, because they are doing a wonderful job.
Yes.
Picking our packages and then sending to the other cities,
yeah.
other states.
So we want to give a big shout out to the postal system for making us look good. And then we do know there are some areas where people, you know, it takes a long time for them to get their packages. All we can say is talk to your postmaster and be nice, you know, say, hey, what can we
do?
Be kind. Yeah, be kind. That's how we work with our postal system. We are kind with them. We send them, you know, give them drinks. We talk to them. We, you know, we're very polite.
Yeah.
So that goes a long way.
And when you go out with your post office, you just go there and looking for the person in charge and tell nice and say, you know, I had this problem, I'm not coming in time or whatever.
Yeah.
And they try to solve your problems. Yeah. Hopefully.
Yeah.
The mailman, your post office listen to you mm-hmm. like.
Yeah. And I believe.
Because we had a lot of issues in Florida.
Yeah. And we've had less issues here.
Yes.
We're not in a major city that has a lot of different things feeding into it, which is good. And we're out of two distribution centers. So we're two distribution centers north. Mm. So that always has a lot to do with it whenever it goes to a place of the sort.
Okay. All right. The next issue is emails, invoices.
Yes. As we're getting into the Nashville Needlework Market pre-order season. which is upon us. And we, how we do those items, we take pre-orders for those items, and then when we come back from market, we issue PayPal invoices. Mm-hmm. First thing is, you don't need a PayPal account to pay a PayPal invoice. You can pay your PayPal invoice with a credit card.
Or debit card.
Or you can also, I believe, you can pay it with a PayPal gift card, because they have those. And we spend a lot of time when we do issue invoices, we itemize each item on your invoice, what it is, how much it costs, and who it's from, you know, because we have a limited amount of space. But we try to put all the information in there. So whenever you get an invoice from us, click it, open it, and then you can see what all the invoice is. Mm-hmm. If you don't, some of us don't open links in emails. I understand that. So what you would do is you would go to your PayPal account at that time, and you could see any open invoices.
Yeah. So we know the invoice if you know pre-order to us.
Exactly.
Yeah. Any email invoice you got it from us is because you pre-order. Sometimes take a while for we got it the product. Mm-hmm. And sometimes we had the time to send you email before, but mostly we do the invoice.
Because PayPal will send you the email.
Yeah. Yes. And talking the invoices, mm-hmm. I want to point it that this Sunday is the 28th.
Yes.
And all the Fox and Rabbit, Atomic Ranch, Bag of the Month, Green Card of the Month, and the Thread of the Month clubs go be out this 28th, what is?
Sunday. Yeah. So we will be picking, packing, shipping all day Sunday.
We no go have Zoom.
No Zoom. So we'll have the packages already in the morning for the mail person when they come.
Yeah. And where I'm pointing that is, if you can pay on the 28th, please let us know. That way your invoice not go be deleted and cancel your subscription. Mm-hmm. Next month, I'm thinking it's too early, but I'm pointing this, and I will repeat it for the couple of weeks. Next month, on the 28th, mm-hmm. we are ready to go to market.
Yes.
And please, if you need pay late, let us know. We will not go be here the first. Well, probably we are in the road the first.
The 29th, I think.
The 29th.
Yeah.
We're going in the road the 29th. If you not pay by the 28th, your invoice next month, you have to wait to probably the 5th or the 6th of the month that we come back. Because the first thing we come back is to unpack your pre-orders. And it's going to be a little crazy, mm-hmm. busy for us. But as Anita pointed, please, if you can, pay your invoice on the 28th.
Yeah.
And we appreciate it.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Now, whips.
We still have another thing. Another question about why we need your zip code when we ask for your PayPal email and your zip code. The zip code reason is, by law, we are required, if you're in the state of Alabama, we are required to collect sales tax from you. And if you're international, we have to charge you international shipping. Yeah. The international price of shipping has gone up at the United Post Office. And the countries that we do ship to is Canada and Australia and I think New Zealand. Yeah. It's only those three international companies we ship to. And the price you pay for shipping is the exact price that the Post Office charges us.
Yes.
So, that because we have to go to the post office and ship it through their system, so that's why it's that price.
Yeah, we cannot ship through PayPal the international.
Yeah,
they no let us. They change the system and they no let us.
Yeah. But I like it going through the post office; it's quicker.
Yeah.
All right, now we can get into the fun stuff. Do we have any finishes?
No, I don't. Of course, you have one.
Oh, I have a finish. So I finished Swing Santa. And this is done on a 32-count solo die.
Wow.
And this was my last 2017 whip. So I have no more 2017 whips. And the designer is Sara. She's an Italian designer.
It's gorgeous.
Yeah, we have some of her other designs in the website right now. With the international designer, sometimes it's hard to get all of their patterns that they make.
So. Mm-hmm.
That is finishes.
Whips.
Let's do.
No, you.
Oh, whip.
Yeah.
Okay. So
I forgot my char, but everybody know my char, right?
All right. So once I finished Swing Santa, I still had more days in the month, and so I was like, I don't know what to stitch. So I decided to pull out Token of Love by Rosewood Manor, because you know Valentine's Day is coming up, and this is the one that this is what the designer suggested. This is what I did with mine. I did it a little bit bright because, you know, it's Valentine's Day. So it's only going to be out for 28 days, maybe 29 every couple of years. So this is what it looks like. And I stitched this on a 32 count grapefruit and the Belsois cranberry. And so I almost finished. I just got a little bit left to do, so hopefully I'll finish that tonight or tomorrow. That being said, we do have a similar color fabric if you wanted to do something similar.
Mm-hmm.
We have an Atomic Ranch fabric. It's pretty close.
It's very close.
It's, yeah.
And I think
it's called Sweet William by Atomic Ranch.
We're looking gorgeous.
So this is Sweet William, and then this would be the thread that I use. So you could probably use that thread or something a little. I think that would look good. So
yeah,
it's just a little bit different, but it's close.
But I'm thinking it's perfect.
Too. Yeah,
yeah. It's a little more orange.
Yeah, it's more
little bitty orangey.
Yeah. So I just wanted to give an option there. And then we have my stocking. I'll go ahead and finish up so Ronnie can take up. So this is my stocking. I did a little bit of stitching on it. I got my 400 plus stitches. Hashtag Ronnie Sock It To Me Style. So I finished this part of the pumpkin. I didn't finish all of it, but I did more than 400 stitches because
guys, you don't have too much left.
What do you mean too much? I have all this down
here. Yeah, but the way you're stitching.
Hey, I'm only doing a little less than 400. Well, maybe this might be 600 stitches.
The little things around.
Yeah, a lot of the little things around is what takes a lot of time. Because you're constantly changing threads, but they're fun.
Yeah.
So, I don't know. I'm sticking with the heel here and the toe because it's a lot of heavy stitching down here because we got this big pumpkin next. Because I would love to get up here and do this part with all the leaves and stuff because that looks like it'd be fast. And then there's the White House there, which is going to be fun too.
Yeah.
So I only stitch on this Thursday just before the day before the video.
And so, you do 400 stitches?
No, it's like six.
Oh, you...
like six. Something like six, but you know.
Mm-hmm. Regular he do 400. But now you know why he do 600 this time.
Well, I wanted to finish my page. Because if I would have stopped like halfway, I would have had like these weird lines with my overdyed thread. So I just went all the way across.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. All right.
Okay.
I'm doing Santa Workshop. Stony Creek.
Mm-hmm.
And this week, undo back stitch, and when I do, it's uncounted, one back stitch,
no,
twice.
Two back stitches is counted as one X?
Oh, yes.
Because we heard that from some other floss tubers, that's what they do.
Yeah. And here's when I am. And you can see now the back stitch there. Let me tell you guys, when I start doing this, when I was a scared for the back stitching.
But it's not that hard.
Well, it's a lot of back stitching.
It's a Stony Creek. Everyone knows it's a lot of back stitching.
Yeah. And I say, well, now I'm going to start doing back stitching that way. Not kick my butt one time.
Yeah, definitely do it as you go when you finish a motif.
Yeah.
And it's good if you look here, it really is nicely broken out. So this guy's not touching anything. So once he's done, you can do all the back stitching. The little mouse is, so it's not like some of the other pieces I've done that had back stitching. It all touched, so it was kind of hard to do it.
This it's because I need, I need to stop over here because here is the hands of Santa. And, you know, I don't want to do the back stitching in the area.
And then have to restitch it. Okay.
But that is when I am, I'm doing, in my count, and do around 600 stitches this year, this week.
Okay.
Yeah, because the back stitching.
Alright. So there's that. Now we want to talk about what's new in the shop.
What is coming back
in the shop? Or back in the shop. So we had some questions about what does that mean. So new in the shop means it's a new release or it's something that we have not had in inventory before. So that would be new to the shop. It's new to us.
Yes.
Back in the shop means we sold out of it and we restocked it. So it's a restock item. So it was so popular, we bought it twice, three times, four times. We keep buying it because it's so popular. So,
yeah.
And that's what that means. So, you guys ready?
We start with the charts?
Yeah. So, we did show this chart last week. And on the website, I gave a couple of suggestions to use cottage garden threads, but we do have the called for color and cotton threads. Mm. Yeah, called for color and cotton threads, which is Battleship. And so we got it listed as the Winter Quaker thread pack on the website. So it'll be that way. If you type in Winter Quaker, it'll show the chart and then it'll show the thread pack. So you need two skeins of thread to stitch this on the called for 28 count. So that's good.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. All right. And then here's another one. This one was pretty hot. This is Valentine's Day Quaker by Primrose Cottage. And this one's back. This is the one that I suggested to use ruby or maybe some other brighter pink. You know, cottage garden threads are... they're going to be at Nashville Market, and there's a couple of designers that's already designing with them. So it's going to be pretty fun. If you're in the club, you're ahead of the game.
Yeah.
All right. And here's the Christmas Quaker, again from Primrose. And this one is done with Classic Colorworks Cherry Cobbler. And on 28 count, it needed three skeins. So there we go. And then we have Autumn Quaker. And here's Autumn Quaker. And this is done with color and cotton thread. We have a thread pack for that also. It's called Pumpkin Pie. But I did notice while I was putting up the Gentle Arts threads, they have a pumpkin pie thread also. And it's very similar, you know, half of one, half the other of the color and cotton. So it's kind of fun. If you can't get one, you got the other. So just saying, you know, I've never met an orange I don't like. so the next one is Christmas Quilt. I love this one.
Yeah.
This is done with Classic Colorworks Cherry Cobbler, two skeins, and Gentle Arts Endive. It is one of my little. I like that style of that motif right there so much because it is. I think it's similar to the one that's done in One Nation, and then also there's a blackbird pattern right there called Raven Bewitched that has those same motifs. It's a very fun pattern because you just kind of after a while you just don't even think about it. You just go through it. This guy is my favorite.
Oh,
it's called Perfect Hot Cocoa.
He is adorable. So cute.
I hope they do a series or something like this, but I don't know. I think he's super cute.
Gorgeous, very small.
Just DMC, a little bit of Weeks, a little bit of Classic Colorworks. So,
and
what's good is we have it a 16 count, 18 count, and 32 count. We have some of that ornament cut from the Christmas box that this would fit on perfectly. So it's just a small piece of the ornament box. Oh, Santa.
I love it.
Yeah. The Aiden one is black, and the linen one is the even weave one is more charcoal. But it still looks cute.
I love it.
I think he's gonna do it.
Oh man,
you gotta finish your stocking before you do that one. That's the way you work. And then this is one of my favorites. This is the Witch Next Door.
That is so cute.
I love a clothesline. They're just so cool. And this is the house is stitched with antique lace, but I think it looks much better when you stitch it with Weeks Dye Works White Lightning, because it's got a little bit of gray in it. So then it would look, when you stitch it long like this, it would look like clapboards, like slats of the wood. So. Mm.
Love it.
Here is Salem Sisters. The Salem Sisters Apothecary. It's just the chart piece in the middle there. That is so cute. I have that one to stitch. I have a lot of their stuff to stitch. I need to start stitching. This one is done just black. Yeah, just 310 or coal, whichever one you like. Or your favorite black, or even
what? I prefer 310.
Or Witching Hour, if you like the purple black Witching Hour. There's all kinds of cool colors because it's witchy stuff.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So we got some of these back in stock. If you pre-ordered these, we had already sent out your email, your invoice
mm-hmm.
for the ones we got in. There are some that we still have some of the Starry Night, the 1, 2, 3 ones. We had to put another reorder in for those. So if you haven't got an invoice on that, that's because you're in the next batch of reorders.
Yeah.
So, but we do have some of these from Blackberry Lane. This is the Journey to Bethlehem ornament. And this is currently on the website.
And thank you to the designer, too, yes. Because she posted our part of our video when we showing her charts mm-hmm. and her website,
yeah,
I believe.
Facebook group, I think.
Her Facebook group.
Yeah, I saw somewhere.
Yeah. Yes.
All right, and then here's the next one. It's just Keeping Watch. So that would be the Three Shepherds. I like that one. That one's cool.
Yeah.
And then here's, I love this one too. Okay, I like all of them. This is the Three Wise Men.
Yeah, I'm sorry, I forgot. All these charms coming with the charms.
Yeah, with the charms and the beads.
Yeah,
to make the ornaments.
Some beads, some charms. Mm-hmm. Oh yeah, no, all beads.
Yeah,
all with the beads.
Okay. All right. Now this is one that's back in the shop. This is North Pole from Kathy Berwick. And I stitched mine on the blue fabric that we got from the Fox and Rabbit Fabric of the Month Club. So I think it'll look good on blue too.
Mm-hmm.
It was a light blue. Like a, yeah. Now we have a couple of letters from Nora. I'm gonna do a little bit of shaking around here. So I'm gonna show them in order because I don't know if some of you may have seen, there's a couple of groups that do Mirabilia, you know, where they change things and colors and all that stuff. So I'm in one of the groups and they took the letters from Nora and they spelt the word joy. So I've always wanted to do that, and I found out that they're still available. So here is J. And what they did is they changed the colors of the little fairy to red. You know, they just modified the colors. So there's J. Mm-hmm.
They're gorgeous. Mm-hmm. I'm working with mine.
Yeah. And then here's the O. And then here's the Y. So you could have joy. Well, oi. Joy.
Oh. Oops.
Joy.
And asleep.
Yeah. And I just noticed that each one of them on the back, she gives them a name. So O is Olivia.
Oh.
And Y is Yardley. I don't know what kind of name.
J is Jordan.
Yeah. So I wonder what R is. You have to find out what your R is.
Yeah.
Yeah. So that's the fairy. So Nora Corbett has two sets of letters. She's got a letters A through Z of fairies and letters A through Z of mermaids. So they're all still available. So here is the J in the mermaid.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow. And the charts are very clear to read too. So here's the J in the mermaid series. There we go. All right. You guys ready? This is gorgeous. Jan Hicks is knocking it out of the park with all of her amazing designs. This is Love. Look at the male and female cardinal. It's not that big. I think it's like 80 stitches by 80 stitches. So it's not very big. Yep, 80 by 80, it's a square. It's done with Weak Style Works, Gentle Arts, Classic Colorworks, DMC. She just couldn't decide who to use. So she has a little bit of everybody. I like that. So
it's beautiful.
It's gonna be pretty hot. So if that's one you like, you better hurry up.
It's beautiful.
Yeah.
Mm. And I love cardinals.
Yeah. And then here's another one from Jan. This is In the Pink, and it's done with Needlepoint Silks, and there is a conversion to DMC. So look at that. That's pretty. It's done like on a darker brown, so any darker brown would look nice. Definitely would have to do a dark color to make the light pinks really pop like that. Yeah. So there's that. And here's, I like this one too. This is a Hopeful Heart Prayer Flag, and it's all stitched and designed with cottage garden threads. So it's a cute little, like you finish a little ruffle down there to finish up this little flag. You know, it could be for Valentine's Day. I mean, you could make it, keep it out for Valentine's Day all the time. It's a little hope there in the heart. It's a fun little piece.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah. All right.
And then, simple finish too.
Yeah. And then we have a couple of charts from Petal Pusher. These are seasonal charts. There's four seasonal charts. Here is Summer Splendor. They're all done with DMC. Okay. And then we have Spring Beauty. Oh, wow, look at that one. Huh. Of course, I like the Autumn Glory because I think the purple trees are really fun. Oops. And then the last one is, okay, be careful now because there's two charts out there with this name. This is Winter Wonderland by Petal Pusher. So there is Winter Wonderland by Petal Pusher. That's why we ask when during Nashville market season, please put the name of the designer and the name of the chart, because, you know, if you only put the name of the chart, who knows what you're going to get.
Mm.
So it's always good to put name of the chart and designer, because a lot of names are recycled.
Yeah, I see that.
Yeah. And you need that. And that is all the charts that's new to the shop.
What is new in the chart?
Now we have fabric, the exclusive GaRon fabric that the guys at Atomic Ranch did for us. It's our image that we had converted into a,
I have to put it in,
yeah,
into
converted four. Into fabric to stitch on. So we have it in Aida and linen. This is the landscape version. While I was seeing this, remember last week we showed the three mushroom girls from Nor Corbett that just came out. You could probably put two of them on here, or maybe all three of them if you wanted them kind of close together. I think that would be cute. They would look nice on there, especially on the vertical.
Ada.
Yep, that's the Ada one. And then we have it in 28 count and 32 linen. All right.
This is the linen.
Again, that's also landscape because it's got the two lanterns there and then the lantern over here. Most framers will only need quarter of an inch to frame, so you won't lose too much of the lantern by the frame because there's, it's over, so
yeah,
you should be fine.
Fold it.
Yeah.
Oops, sorry. I'm trying to show the ends.
Yeah, how much he's got rolled over.
Fold
yeah.
it. I have folded to show you guys.
All right, and then here is the portrait version. So we have the Adas and the linens all in the portrait version as well. So this would be for like a tall mirror or the Olivia would look nice on here with the one. And then there's another one. I think there's a Gia, there's a couple of them that I think would look nice on here.
Yeah. That's beautiful.
It's always nice to have a light fabric that's got color to it. See, there's all this detail down here. It's not all muddy. it's, you can see all the little individual leaves and everything. And that's what I like. And then I like the fact that this is a light color here. So whatever you stitch there is gonna pop. It's still gonna look good, I think.
Yeah. All right. What is new? What is back? Now we go, what is coming to the shop?
Nope, no, that's later. We're gonna do, oh yeah, we can do this.
What is coming?
Yeah. Okay, because that's designer focus. So now,
I'm been working with a little
fabric.
A little. You remember my word? I forgot the word. A little batch of bags. This one is coming back. What is Winnie the Pooh?
Okay, wait. I think we need to say the bag sale is going to be on February the 10th. Yes. So you have time. He's still working on them, so these are...
This is not finished. Yeah,
you'll see pens, so yes, we know there's pens on there, and the name is not on there, so they're not fully finished, but he wanted to show you what it's going to look like.
Yeah, because next, the 10th. This is the Winnie the Pooh, what is coming back. Hopefully. We'll find some print, some fabric.
Hopefully I get one this time.
This one, maybe.
It's a cardinal
this
bag.
This one is the cardinal. This one was last year bag of the month.
For January. This would be perfect to put the Jan Hicks project in.
Yes, with the cardinals.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. There, this is...
I love this one.
Coming back to a couple of these ones.
Yeah, so this one there I was thinking of... because Dirty Annie's got a couple of Louisiana pieces.
Yes.
I think it would be cool to put inside that bag. Like she's got the lobster, the Christmas lobster, a bunch of the lobsters and other things from.
This is gnomes, Valentine's gnomes.
Yeah.
And this is the inside.
Mm, yummy, I love the suckers.
Yep. There, this one I was having, what is called the word? I don't was sure when I'm going using outside, but it's long time I don't have chickens.
I love this one.
To me, but I love the inside too for outside.
Yeah, but I love the fact that it looks very French.
And that is chickens. And because I have many flowers and say, okay, chickens go be out and I have long time no make chickens. This beauty, flamingos.
Uh-oh.
I love the pastels.
Oh, it's very pretty.
Yes. I love the light, bright pastels.
Mm-hmm. I like this one.
This is beautiful flowers.
It looks like wisteria to me.
Yes. Look like, but it's not.
Yeah. Something but similar.
This is the...
Or lilacs, maybe.
Flowers. We find another print with flamingos. Was very tropical, very Floridian, this one.
Yeah, I like that one.
There, this one we have it before too, and we found more print, more fabric, and we say, why not?
Yeah.
So not too many bags in the same print that I can make it. And I love these wildflowers.
Yeah, I love the wildflowers. I like the inside fabric.
And the inside.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
And then for our global travelers who like to cruise all the time.
Yep. We have this one. Or those who like boats.
Yeah, look at the anchors in there.
Yeah.
I like that one too.
This one I'm calling the African print because it's very African and see.
Very tribal.
Shows and it's, I love it.
Yeah.
Yeah. I love this kind of prints.
Mm-hmm. Very organic.
There we have more wow. This one have wildflowers and have strawberries.
Oh, I just saw the strawberries.
When I grab it in the store and say, okay, this one is very similar or this one.
Yeah.
But then I see the brightest flower and the strawberries. And I said, okay, they are very different.
And then the inside is the dragonflies.
We go with the puppies. I cannot find kitties. because they know how no kitties in the store.
Yeah.
And I'm fine puppies.
What was the inside?
I'm sorry. Little bones.
Alright.
And this one is my favorite. Yeah. I love this print. You can judge the print. I love this one.
It's very graphic. Yeah. I love that.
And that is the inside.
Okay, that does look good together. Ooh, I like that.
Yeah. We had different fabric for inside of this one. And one lady, no, they don't have too many. One lady come and said, how many are you gonna take all this fabric? And I say, why? And he said, because I need three jars. And I said, you know what? Take it. I can find another one. Gorgeous. And I love that one.
Yeah, I like that one better. But yeah. I love this one.
This bag is perfect for something like Erica Michaels' series.
Berries.
The birds.
Oh, yeah.
It's coming. Because is the eve.
Yeah, but what I like is it's got almost the same pattern, but like tone on tone inside as the outside.
Yes.
That was so cool.
And the last but not least is with flowers, with butterflies.
Very bright.
I love the inside, too.
Of course, it's Gary Green.
Yeah. You can not see too much the green, but it's very limey, bright, with dots.
Yeah.
Yeah. These bags go be ready for
February 10.
February 10.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
We looked at the calendar this time.
No one is done. Complete.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So there's that. Mm-hmm. And I'm checking my stuff, checking it twice. Now we're going to do, normally we would pick up and do the next letter, but because this is the last video of the month, we're going to do our next month's showcase, our next month's designer focus.
Yes.
So then when that letter comes up, we won't talk about that designer because we've already showed you. We don't want to oversaturate you with the same patterns over and over.
This week is, first of all, this week is D and E.
Mm-hmm.
Next week will be F and H. No.
F and G. Yeah.
Oh.
Yeah, F and G. Because there's a lot of G's.
Oh, I'm thinking it was H.
No.
No, okay, never mind.
H will, yeah. So
cut here.
We're not cutting. We don't cut. We're not going to cut what's cute.
Okay. All right. I messed it up my head. I'm thinking next week was H.
Yeah. Okay. So February's designer, focus designer is Heartstring Samplery. She has got a lot of different kinds of patterns and lots of fun patterns. So mm-hmm. I think you're going to find some, almost had a sneeze. You're going to find some really good patriotic pieces, some sampler pieces, some pretty cool pieces. I
put the other ones in the table and give me the box.
Oh, okay.
I need the box with the cardboard.
Okay, you need the cardboard too.
No, I don't have the cardboard.
Oh, okay.
Thank you.
We'll get it together. Alright, so the first one. Oh man. I need this one in my collection.
Okay.
This is a patriotic one. It says a plant of rapid growth. Oh my gosh.
Love it.
I love the patriotic ones. Liberty when it begins to take root. It's is a plant of rapid growth. It's a quote by George Washington.
And the one part and I found out today is she take a lot of time for write it what is about the chart.
Yeah, she's got she puts all her inspiration
there. Every chart have in the back what is the inspiration for the chart. Yeah.
Okay, there's that one.
Yes, sir. All
right. And then the next one here, this is Advent Season Ornament Set. We showed this one in when it first came out. I love this one.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. And this is one that I have stitched. Baby, it's cold outside, and it has been cold outside, but not lately. But
no.
I love this one. And what I like about this one, you know, it's like a big house. I'm not a big, big house stitcher, but if you look at my whips, I just lied. I do have a lot of whips at big houses, but this part right here is stitched like every other square. So it goes really fast.
And she put the sun in the back.
Oh, cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, so it goes a lot faster because there's a lot of spacing. See that? There you go. So you can see that all the background color is from the fabric. That's pretty cool.
Yeah, I just noticed the sun is in there.
All right, and then we have Baby Got Backstitch. He's got backstitch. So she did a lot of these. She's got four in the series that do a dark fabric with a light thread that's kind of funky like this. Okay. Be Still My Heart. It's a stitching mat and a needle book. Oh, this is cute. So there's, I don't know if we can see that. I think this one over here is still a little crooked. I have to work on that one again. I need more tape because I tried to tape them down.
I ain't no worry about the crooked picture because all these pictures gonna be moved.
Yeah. So this is Charlotte Ash, 1827. Look at that rose. I love that border and that rose. That's very cute.
Mm.
That, you got it already. And this is Christmas Bell Sampler. Okay, someone had asked that if we could read the sayings. The Child's Prayer was like a book and it was over one. So I could not even see that.
Yes.
And this is Christmas Bell Sampler. I heard the bells on Christmas Day, their old familiar carols play, wild and sweet, the words repeat, peace on earth, goodwill to men.
Thank you.
So there. Now you guys are all singing the song, but I love that. Okay, there's a couple of these. They all look similar, but it's a notebook journal cross-stitch cover.
Mm.
So this is a Dream Journal, and this is the sci-fi science fiction version. So you could, isn't that cute? And then I think she's got a couple of other ones like that too, so you could kind of like have cross-stitch book covers just for decoration. I wouldn't. And this one I think is very fun because it's broken up. It's got two different ways to stitch it, so it's kind of fun. You could do both like she has it here, but you could pick and choose which one you like the most. This is Ding Dong Merrily on High. So you got the pattern to do the banner part up there and then the bottom part. So it's almost the same pattern, just broken up different ways. I like the banner. And here's another long one. This is Psalms 23. You guys know what it is, so you could read it. This is Emma Fisher, 1859. So this is her sampler. How old was she? She was 15. So of course she did a fancy one at 15. Some dedication there. Oh, this is cute. So this is a French flea market biscornu. So if you like blue, look at that. This part right here is pretty cool too. Just the weaving in of how it looks. So you stitch the front and back and then you turn them to the off and then you stitch them together. That's all I know. Mm-hmm. You have to do a biscornu.
Yeah, and she explained what biscornu mean in the back of the shirt.
Oh, okay, cool.
So biscornu is a French word that means bizarre.
Bizarre, crooked, skewed, crooked, quirky, crooked, irregular.
Irregular.
So I guess we're all biscornus. I'm a biscornu too.
Biscornu one.
All right, here's Five Songbirds Pendrum. And it's an Adam and Eve type of sampler, but it's turned into a drum. I think it's Adam and Eve. Yeah, Adam and Eve. That's pretty cool. Right. And this is Grounding force. Cross stitch is my grounding force. I would agree. It's a cross stitch fairy. That's pretty. See, this is one of those quirky ones because it's stitched on black and it's pretty cool. It's a little different. And here is another music one. It says, "Hear the Angels Sing." And it's the song right there. "Hear the Angels Sing," the song is what you stitch. Okay. Ooh, this one's cool. Here is honeybee pen drum.
Look at that. That's so cute.
I love, okay. You see how it, look how it's stitched together right
there.
So she's got it where when you stitch it, that's your seam in the back when you turn it into a drum. And there's a cute little top, a little bottom. This is the top, this is the bottom, and there's the queen. Oh my gosh.
That is gorgeous.
Yeah. I like drums. This is Hope Song. This was in one of her latest releases. Hope Song. That's cool. And this says, "My heart remembers hope when the winter song sings. When the winter bird sings." I said song. I can't read. All right. Here is, oh, Fear Less, Hope More. This is a piece I think she made for, okay, I don't know.
For what?
I don't remember now. I don't think it was right. I'm not going to say anything.
Oh, okay.
So this is cool. Oh, I love this one. I'm turning into a red sampler, Christmas red sampler person. Joyous All Together. This little pillows, like at that. Joyous All Together. Super cool. I mean, you could pop more colors in there if you wanted to. A little red, a little green somewhere. But. And here would be a companion piece, Joyful, Joyful. And this has got like the bigger piece and then it's got three little motifs there to do. So this is the, if you stitched it with the darker colors and then the companion, maybe the companion piece, see it's a little more faded. But you could stitch both of them in the same color or similar colors and then put them as a collection. I think they would go good together. And here's another reproduction. This is Kate Adkin, A-D-K-I-N. And this is her reproduction. That's cute. "Key to My Heart. You hold the key to my heart." Oh, that's cute. I love it. There's a key. She attached a key to it. Just put a little loop there to hang the key. "Let Your Light Shine In." See, here's a fun one. That's definitely fun. Uh-oh.
Another patriotic. Ooh, I love that.
Yeah. This one's a berry and a drum. So it's the Liberty pin drum and the Justice Needleberry. Ooh, Justice. I like that. I like that. Definitely. The Justice Berry, Needleberry. That is cool. All right, this is Letters to the Cross Stitch Nation. So it's so cool. It's all the stitchers, all the, everybody's representative. That's really cute.
Yeah.
Yeah, stitchers, all the colors. Mercy Magason. 1849. It is an Adam and Eve sampler.
Mercy Magason.
Maybe.
Maybe what?
Magason?
Mercy Magason.
Magason.
Magason. Okay. 1849.
All right. And this is My Wish for You. May All Your Dreams Come True. Oh, look at it. Flowers. And is that a moth? It looks like a moth.
Yep.
So it's a moth. Of course it would be a moth because it's stuck about dreams.
My wish
for you.
Okay.
This is My Necessity. You're the cream in my coffee. You're the sole in my shoe. My necessity. I'd be lost without you. I love this piece. And it's got like little coffee beans and stuff all over there.
I love when you say that words to me.
I love it when you make my coffee for me. It keeps me going. Here's a reproduction. This is Perry Pryor. So she shows the original and then her reproduction. Wow. Look at that.
Put original, let's beat it up.
Wow. Well, I mean, it's old, fabric. Huh? It's old, yeah.
Not saying what year is that one?
Nope, it didn't.
No.
Okay, it says February the 21, 18, age 7. Perry Pryor was 7 years old when he worked his stitches and finished. Oh, this is a boy sampler.
That is cool.
Those are very rare. You don't see a lot of that. Oh, that's cool. And he was 7 when he did that. Oh, my
wow.
gosh.
Wow.
That's pretty cool. Okay. I like that.
Wow.
All right. I got to stitch it because it's a boy sample. I said I would stitch one. All right. This is Really Friends. There is nothing I would not do for those who are my really friends.
1 minute back. Huh? This proves the males stitching in that time of day.
Oh, yeah.
I did not.
There you go. There is, what was this one? This was Really Friends.
Wow.
So that's, and we got the next stack. Okay. And this is the Sunday Stitchers. This is the collection of hymns to stitch and sing. So it's, so there's 12.
Whoa.
And I think we have them individually too. So this is a book of all 12. When she first did these, there was a small collection of us cross stitch stores that had the individual ones that sold them before the book was released. So we had sold them individually. And then, because we were in that club. And then she put the book all together a few years later.
So. The feeling of this paper is so good.
Yeah. And this is Sweet Land of Liberty. This is one that I have to stitch. It's cute. Our hearts are stitched together. This is stitched together. It's in one of the little tins. See, this is a fun little piece for like a retreat piece because it's very cute. You're not spending years and years to stitch on it, and you're still putting enough of yourself in your piece to give away, and just fit in one of those little tins where you can finish it another little way. Super cute.
Yeah, it is.
And this is another one for me. This is Say Coffee. If you can't remember my name, just say coffee and I'll turn around. Isn't that fun? See how it's faded in? This right here is, there's stitching over here, but it's deliberately stitched to match the fabric to blend in. So that's where.
That'll be hard to stitch.
No, because when you're up close stitching it, you can see it. It's just when it's finished, it starts fading away.
Okay.
And here is my piece, my favorite piece. I will be starting this February 1st. Scary Sampler. Look at that. Look, there's a Death Star right there. There's pterodactyls on this piece. There's Men in Black, the roach on a tree. She's got all the movie reference or book references on the back of all the things in there. There's the angel, the Don't Look angel from Doctor Who. There's alien heads blended in with the flowers. It's in the border. This thing has got all of my favorite sci-fi and scary movies in there. And it's just like, It's going to be so much fun. There's the snake from Beetlejuice right there. And
she was doing this one. She was doing this one when we were in market.
Because I asked for a Halloween piece for so many years. I kept asking.
I remember that one.
And she said, look, I got one close. This is the best I can do.
Yeah.
Because she doesn't do Halloween. So, but I mean, her pieces are amazing.
Yeah.
And this is Seahorse Soray Biscornu. Oh, there's a little mermaid on here. So here's your little mermaids, little seahorses, little sea life. That's a cute, cute, cute little piece. That's a stitching in the wall piece for a smalls exchange. All right, this is Springtime Pendrum. Oh, it's got tulips on it. I love tulips. Hopefully we'll have some this year. If the deer don't eat them. And this is Sting. Remember when we had that piece? Yeah. Sting like a bee. Look at that. Sting like a bee. Oh. Those are cool bees. Those are really cool bees.
Yeah.
Got the little stinger right there. Bing, bing, bing. All right, now here are some of the individual patterns from the Sunday Stitches, which was in that big book. So here are some of the individual ones. This is Be Thou My Vision. So like if there's a certain one that you like, so you just get that one that you wanted.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And this is Sunday Stitches Blessed Assured. Look at that. Look at those colors. That's a really cute one with all framed with the flowers. And this is Sunday Stitches, Oh, the Deep, Deep Love of Jesus. Mm-hmm. Oh. And now we're in, okay. I guess they were all mixed in. This is.
No, because that is M, that is S, the Sunday.
Oh, okay.
And I want to keep it the series
together,
that way.
Yeah. This is. Ye Old Noel.
Oh, that one is the last one. Oh, yeah, no, it's fine.
This is pretty. Look at the colors. It's got like pinks in there. This is Ye Old Noel. Oh, that's cute. It's not very bright, but it's kind of cool. I mean, it's not really, it's not a deep, rich, Christmassy colors, but it's like very soft. Mm. That's the right word. There you go. I knew I'd get there.
Yeah, I'm thinking that jump. Jumbo, when you pull it out from the,
Oh, maybe.
Yeah, this one jumping.
Okay, so now we have
The water.
Until We Meet Again.
I love that one. That is when I found out she write it out in the back.
Oh, all the stuff.
What is the mean? This one she make for one retreat, and she had different name.
Yeah,
and because was the pandemic.
Mm-hmm.
And the retreat was made by Zoom.
Oh, okay.
And it's what she explained there.
Oh, cool.
What, yeah.
Yeah, it says, so may your dreams come true.
I cannot read the other one.
Oh, there's flowers in from there.
Yeah.
We meet again. From something until we meet again.
Yeah.
But there we go. There's a real flower in front of the stitching. Oops. But it's really pretty. I love the flowers.
Yeah.
This is the dressmaker's sewing kit. So it's got like three pieces that you stitch. It's got the drum, a little book there, a little tray piece that you can put in there. So there's that one. Ooh, I don't think I've seen this one before. This is the HF 1837 sampler. Oh, Jesus, Mary, and a lobster. Huh? Okay. Where do you see that at? I don't get that. Jesus, Mary, and a lobster. Interesting. Interesting. All right, and then we have some more Sunday Stitches.
That one jumped.
Yeah, these jumped.
Oh, because I see the When I Survey.
Yeah, this is When I Survey. Love so divine demands my soul, my life, my all. That's another Sunday. We have to put all the Sunday ones back together.
I know.
This is Sunday Stitches. To God be the glory. So it's a short month, and she's got quite a bit of them that could be relatively done within the 28 days. So I think you could start and finish some. Now, Scary Sampler is not going to be done in 28 days or 29 days, even if there is a leap year. That's a big sampler, and I'm looking forward to stitching on that.
Now, we'll be right back in a minute because I have to move boxes.
Yep. So, that's the it of our regular video. So, we are going to be taking a break, cleaning up a little bit, and then we'll be doing the shop to shop, letter D and E. So, we'll be right back. Okay, we're back. One more thing before we do the video. Before we show shop the shop, I'll cut and paste. Gary, cut and paste this and put it back over there. You know where it goes. Okay, so Nashville Market. We're starting to get the emails from some of the designers. And of course, each designer has a due date that we have to send our pre-orders into them to make sure we are guaranteed to get the patterns. Otherwise, we're going to be buying them at market if they're available or however it goes.
Mm-hmm.
So the first one, and these have been loaded on the website. We have a section in our website called 2024 Nashville Needlework. And when you click on that section, it'll take you to a page, and then there'll be a filter there that says by manufacturer, or it says all manufacturer, filter by all manufacturer. Click on that. And then you can look up these designers that we're about to tell you about.
Mm-hmm.
And we'll pop the pictures in a little bit later. I'm going to try and see if I can pop in the pictures of all the new releases coming out weekly. This is going to be a long video. Okay. So the first designer is Yarn Tree. And that is the cookbook. And the due date for those pre-orders emailed to us is February 14th. Which is coming close.
Yes. Yeah, that's why around the corner.
Yeah, that's why I want to really try to keep you guys as interactive as we can on these pre-orders, so we can get our pre-orders in time. The Blue Flower, her pre-order deadline is February the 16th.
Mm-hmm.
And then today we got in Cotton Pixel, and her deadline is the 10th, February the 10th.
Wow.
So, we got quite a bit of deadlines. Fiber on a Whim, their deadline was January the 11th. We already missed it. So if we don't do pre-orders for fabrics because we can't always get the fabrics based off of what the designer is releasing and stuff like that. So when we go to the market, we will buy what fabric we can get and what we can see, because fabric can always be ordered at a later date.
Mm-hmm.
We can always order fabric at a later date from a designer. We have a wall of fabric over there already. So we probably already have the colors or similar color in stock, just to say.
Yeah.
All right. So now, with that being said, we're going to do shop to shop. We're back again. Hopefully I did all the split and splice and stuff. I added the Nashville stuff in, right? So are you ready to see letter D and E designers from shop to shop?
Yeah. Somebody asking if we go do it the A and B in the question. We already do A, B, and C.
Yes. And what we're going to do is every week, when you click on the drop-down menu of the video, we're going to list each video and what letter we designer we did in that video, because we're going to have about 20 some videos. So I want to make sure they're all there so that when you do a few years later or whatever, you know which one it is. That's the easiest way to say it and find it and see it.
Yes. And we remind you every week
that we added it at the bottom.
Yes.
So, and that also is where you would click on find the link to our website to do the pre-orders.
Yes.
So the first designer that we have in the letter D is Darling and Whimsy. And these are done with cottage garden threads. So this is Flamingo. Darling, oops, fingers in the way, fat finger in the way. There you go. Right there, and it's called Flamingo. So it's done with, let's see, it's cut, cottage garden threads. No, wait, this one is actually done with color and cotton, or DMC. Sorry about that. And this is the Quirky Turtle. What are you using? Okay. Oh. This is the Quirky Turtle from Darling and Whimsy. Darling and Whimsy. Okay, get my words right, Gary. So there's that one.
I was distracted looking at correcting this.
So I corrected myself.
Good.
All right. So the next one we have is Dames of the Needle. She does also some design work. And this is number one, A Year of Costumes. So it's a snowman costume.
Hmm.
So she did one for every month. This was the only one we have left.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, look at this. How convenient. We just talked about a lobster bag, and we got the designer who likes us to stitch, design Louisiana stuff. So you'll see some cool stuff that should go in the lobster bag. This is a savior. The designer is Dirty Annie's.
Yes.
And her Southern style is so sweet, and sometimes you bless your heart. It's so sweet. So this is A Savior Is Born. Look, isn't that pretty? That's a great pillow. And you could probably do a stand-up with that. You know how they do the round stand-ups? That way it would look, instead of just a pillow finish.
Mm-hmm.
All right. And this is Bayou Santa. So he's got gators instead of reindeer. And then we have Bikini Martini. Bikini, I thought you said martini. See, isn't that cool? I love her her point of view. It's fun because, you know, everything doesn't have to be so serious. This is a Boston Tea Party. He's in a teacup and he's having a party. Oh, look at this one. Boo Cat. I remember when this one, I like this one. Mm-hmm. Look at those heels. He's got his heels on. Mm-hmm. And this is here's another funny one. This is called Cactus. Cactus. And the one in the middle is the cat with the little things like a cactus. All right. And here is one of the Gulf Coast treasures. This is crawfish. So she's got crawfish there. And here is a Christmas topiary. Oh, look at that. Oh, okay. That's cool.
I know it's cute. I like that one.
But I like this one here. I saw this one. This Country Christmas. Look at those boots. Talk about stitching on the angle. You're like da 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 da. But there's no quarter stitches. It's all full stitches, so it's fun stitching. And there's no back stitching, Ronnie.
Mm.
You can do your country Christmas.
I like that.
It looks fun.
Cute, yeah.
It looks difficult, but it's not when you look at the pattern. It's just like da-da-da-da, crazy.
Yeah.
All right, this is Dashing Through the Snow. Look at that. Look at our weenie dogs, or what's it? I call dash hounds. Dotsons.
Yeah, that's so cute.
They're weenie dogs. Deja Poo. The feeling that one has seen and heard this crap before. That's a bathroom piece. You got to put it in the bathroom or in a meeting room. Deja Vu. And this next one here is Dance Like a Mermaid. And this one has a little starfish with it. Yep. Dance Like a Mermaid.
And a little star.
Mm-hmm. This is... Dance Like a Mermaid and Drink Like a Pirate. Fun and sweet. Sassy and sweet. And this is... this one just came out. Extra Fries. Exercise. I thought you said extra fries. That's fun. I gotta be careful with these single patterns. I gotta make sure I lay it right.
Yeah.
This is one of my Thanksgiving ones that I wanted to stitch. It's called Fat Pants. Look at all those, all that Thanksgiving stuff there. Yummy. I was like, Happy Thanksgiving, get your fat pants ready.
No comments.
Mine stretch, so.
Yeah.
This is Frosty. Look at this. Isn't this cute? Frosty with a little baby.
Oh,
it's called Frosty.
Man. That is gorgeous.
I know it's got snowflakes inside the squares, but it's still super cute. And you're not doing a bunch of white, you know, it's not solid white stitching for a snowman. You got something in there you can just work on a little bit here, a little bit there. I think it's fun. Yeah. It's very fun.
I love that one.
Mm-hmm. And this is German Santa. Still waiting for a French Santa, you know, a Santa with a French poodle. I put it out there.
Yeah.
And then we have, this one just came out. This is Hissing Booth. I know, I think of Caroline when I see this one, Hissing Booth.
Yeah. Do it that way down.
Okay.
That way.
And this is... I love my cat. I don't think it's cat. It's possum.
I love that one.
I
From
think we
the
were,
day we got it, and say,
we were supposed. I was so supposed funny. To stitch this one with somebody. Was that Andrea? Andrea, were we supposed to stitch this together?
I don't know.
I think there was someone we were supposed
this
to stitch.
Cute. All
right. This is Kissing Booth because dogs like to kiss. There you go. All right. Oh yeah, we did. We showed this one too. This is Ronnie.
Lache pas la patate.
Yeah. Don't drop the potato.
Yeah. Yeah. And somebody say that. Somebody send the name.
Yeah. It's on the back of the pattern too.
All right. Probably in Spanish too.
Could be. All right. Here's another button. This is Love You. Just in time for a quickie little Valentine's Day one.
Coming with a little button.
It's a little wooden heart. All right, now we have Mr. and Miss America. She's got a whole series of Mr. and Miss.
That's so cute, too.
Mr. and Miss America. And then we have Mr. and Miss Autumn. What was he going to do? I love his green jacket. Super cool. And then we have, of course, Mr. and Miss Dracula. Look at her.
I can't believe you're gonna do this one.
I know. There's so many I want to do. I've got to hurry up and do them. All right. Then we have Mr. and Miss Summer. Look at that. Bikinis and margaritas.
Oh, let me see the picture. Oh, no. Too skinny.
Mr. and Miss Summer.
With the old-fashioned
bathing suits.
Bathing suits.
Yeah. Here you go. Mr. and Miss Western.
I love that one. That is so cute.
Yeah, that's a fun one. All right, Mardi Gras trio. So all three of those patterns are in there just in time for, it's Mardi Gras in March, right? So,
I don't know where Mardi Gras is.
I think it's one of those holidays that move around a lot. Too.
Remember.
Here is Merry Christmas, y'all.
That is for me.
We know a guy who says that, don't we?
No, I don't know. We don't know who.
Who says y'all every time he makes a post?
I don't know. You know y'all.
All right. Here is Old Salem Sanitarium. Ooh, wow. And it's stitched on blood splatter.
Oh, yeah. I remember that one.
Yeah. We have that fabric. I think we have some of it.
Yeah. We still have the fabric. Who was the designer of the fabric? I don't remember.
Jody. Still City Stitches. Flosstuber. And this is Patriotic Tags. This is cute. Look at that.
Oh, man.
Now we need Patriotic
Flag.
No, look at the USA.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Well.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, excuse me. I was looking at the flag in the back.
Yeah.
The. Oh, is the chart?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm almost showing. Yeah, I was looking at the flag in the back.
All right.
But I don't see it, the chart.
Yeah. Here's another little heart.
Yeah.
This is perfect. Perfect. And the little blue. It's a little blue wooden heart that goes right there.
There.
Yeah, there you go.
There. Oh, there.
Mm-mm-mm. I'm getting up front and personal with all the designers. I like this. This is peppermint bark.
Yeah, weenie dogs.
I know. I'm seeing a trend here. She's done more weenie dogs. And
maybe what she have in common. We have to ask in the market.
All right. And then here is the welcome pineapple.
Yeah. That was a hard.
It still is.
Pattern.
It's very cool how it's the colors and everything.
Yeah,
definitely like that.
You know, like doing down, you can do it up.
Yeah, you can flip it.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what's nice about the pattern.
Yeah.
This is Pumpkin Patch.
Oh.
These are cats hiding in quilted pumpkins. Those are quilted pumpkins, I would say.
Oh, they're so cute.
Yeah. You know.
I like that one.
Yeah. Real men have curves. Real men.
And close my mouth.
All right. Here is Rudolph. Rudolph. It's silent. Yeah, we had that discussion. So it's Rudolph. I love him. He is so cute. Super, super cute. All right, and then here is Southern Sampler. This is a house, a pink house in the bayou. It's Southern Sampler. It's a famous pink house in the bayou in Louisiana. This is Sister Sampler. See, she's got a wide range of styles and things that she does. That's kind of fun. I like this one. Oh, there's a little shamrock. Sassy Lassie.
And have a
gold four-leaf clover. Oh, it's a three-leaf clover. It's a clover.
There.
Yeah. So what's fun is she gives you the option. She gives you the option of putting the button, or she has a chart that you could stitch the shamrock. Depends on what you want to what you do. Which is kind of fun. It's nice to have options.
Yep.
Yeah. And then here is Santa Claus. Oh, and it comes with the little, we can't take it off.
No, you cannot take it off.
Oh, wait. I can show it this way.
Oh, okay.
All right, so here is Santa Claus. And see, it's got these two metal pieces right there on the tree.
Claws.
And here.
What does it say?
I don't know. And there's the little metal
little
piece.
Fish and.
It's a fish skeleton and a mouse.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. And then we have Santa Paws. Well, she's made that. I can't show that one at all. So Santa Paws, and it's a little silver doggy bone. It's right in the middle of the chart.
Yeah.
Really? That's a Chihuahua. Okay, now we have Southern Magnolia from the Gulf Coast. Southern Flower. And then we have, say this very easily, Ronnie. What is this pattern called?
Face it.
No, you have to say the whole word.
Face it.
Sheet face. Faced. It's cute. I love that.
Yeah, because he say and say it, this could be sounds different than what does that mean. You got me one time.
All right. I guess I'm the trophy husband.
Maybe I am.
So we need to stitch it twice.
Yeah.
All right. That's cute. Okay. And then we have Feed Me and Tell Me I'm Pretty.
I love that one. That one is so gorgeous.
Yeah. This one goes with the possum, I think. It's funny.
Yeah, he's so cute.
See, this is a Stitching in the Wild piece.
Yeah.
Because it's very wild.
Oh, but how big is?
Oh. Well, the finished size would be 5 inches by 7 inches. A little too big because it's 6 by 6. Oh, well. But you could stitch on it at Stitching in the Wild.
Yeah.
I wonder how big that possum one is. I like that one. All right, this
is messy, but it still can be.
Oh, this one is on my list to stitch. I love this one. This is the Ring Mistress.
Can't believe you haven't started it yet.
Ring Mistress. Look at that. Oh my God. Look at those. There's skulls up in here. She is so cool. Very New Orleans. I would say it's very New Orleans to me. And she gives you a chart there with the legs for the back stitching. For the fishnets. And this is how most of you guys have met us. We met on the internet.
That's true. Yeah.
So that's super
fun. Cool
logo
for you do it.
Yep. Hashtag we met on the internet.
I like it, that one.
All right. And here is another. Did this one have little buttons? Mm-hmm. No. It tells you how to paint buttons. There's instructions on how to make the buttons look like this. So this one's in my stash. I know this one. Winter Reindeer. Look at that with the little red. They got little red socks on. That's it. Little red socks.
Red and white socks.
Yeah. Super cute. And then here is Winter Robin. So you got the couple. And you got the independent. We call them independent, not single.
Why?
They're independent. They don't need to be around a lot.
Is that weedle?
No. Introvert, extrovert.
I'm cutting that weedle.
All right. And just for that, y'all ain't right. If you were down, just look through Dirty Annie's charts. She'll make you happy by the end of looking through all her charts. I mean, it's so fun. There's no button that time. Okay. There's that.
That was
Dirty Annie's.
Dirty Annie's charts.
Okay.
For the D.
Okay. And now we are in E. We have, I think Dirty Annie has a monopoly on There's three designers. Yeah, we have three designers under D. James and the Needle and Darling and Dipsy. Yes. All right. So now we have E.
This is just in her that she is Monopoly and she's not.
No. She's so fun.
All right.
All right. So now we have E. This is EJV Designs.
Yes.
And this is Blue Bonnets.
I'm thinking I made that one.
No, you made the yellow rose.
No, the it's a boot with the
yeah. So this one is on Ronnie's list.
Yes.
Alright. And the next one is the Halloween Eagle. Okay, I want to open this. Can I read it? I'm not a crow or blackbird or a tree. Oh, I'm not a crow or a blackbird in a tree. Never more a raven, quote Poe. I'm
majestic.
Confident and regal, majestic and beautiful. I am a Halloween eagle. I was like, okay. But isn't it cute? I mean, it's all backstitched words. So it's you do a lot of heavy stitching of the bird and the moon and the word Halloween and then backstitch the rest. So cute. That would probably work very well on that. I don't know if the fabric is too dark. The service fabric from Fox, from Atomic Ranch that we had a couple months ago. This is the Indian paintbrush, which is, isn't it a cousin of the Blue Bonnet?
I think so.
It's the, because they have like a red one and a, this is the Indian paintbrush. Okay.
And you say cousin when it's in a
well,
flower?
Similar. I don't know. I don't make up my own words. You guys, I just make up things.
Yeah, I don't know. You say cousin.
Sister, brother, brother flower? Sister flower?
Yeah,
this is the Yellow Rose of Texas. Ronnie did stick stitch on. And I think you took it home, took it to your sister, right?
No. That one,
uh-huh.
Where I made it in stitch alone. With Andrea and
Anna,
mm-hmm. and somebody else. I'm thinking. I don't remember. It's my first
stitch along,
mm-hmm. and I make it. And my friend in Texas, her mother passed, and was her favorite. Was her favorite flower.
Oh, okay.
And I'm sending it to my friend.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. That one in the boot, I'm thinking of sending to her.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay.
She's having a hard time and...
Yeah.
I'm sending to her.
All right. So now we have a...
That was EJV Designs.
Yep.
And now we're going with...
Erica Michaels.
Erica Michaels. Wow. Are you ready?
Are you ready? Okay.
Let's take a coffee.
I think... This one is should be under X, a Q. Okay. We'll set this aside for now because it's five parts. So I don't want to mess it up. So first one is Three Wise Women. Three wise women brought nappies, formula, casserole. They stayed for babysitting, tea, and laundry. They didn't bring other things. Three wise women. That's a cute one. All right. You get the plastic
in. Yes, sir.
All right. And now, oh, wow, look at this one. I remember this one. This is a mini sampler book. That's good. So this is the mini sampler book. Look at that. There it is. So it gives the instructions on how to make it that way. And look, it opens up as an accordion when you stitch it all together and make it a little book like that. Super cute. I love it that it's all green. Mm-hmm. And then we have Shepherd's Care number one. Where's number one? So you got the three patterns there. She always gives you a lot to stitch in her books and stuff. And then here's the second one. This is Shepherd's Care two. So I think she took a sampler and made these multiple patterns. If I remember right. If I'm remembering.
That's so cute.
Mm-hmm. Now we have Abundant Table. May the abundance of this table never fail and never be less. thanks to the blessings of God who has fed us and satisfied our needs. To him be the sorrowful forever, the glory forever in peace. Let us eat this food which the Lord hath promised for us. Bless the Lord for his sacrifice. The G looked like an S. I'm sorry. I was like trying to figure out the word as I was reading it. Sorry. Look at those purples. Look at that. It is really pretty. Is it a reproduction? Oh, wow. Look at the original. Look how faded that was. Look how tiny that is, too. So she made it easier for us to stitch. Okay. Now we have alpha berries. I love these. Look at this one right here is my favorite with the alphabet on the angle.
You made that one, no?
I made one of them, I think. Oh. I think I made one of them.
Yeah, I make so many berries, I don't know what you have.
I know, and I have so many more to make. My goal is to stitch all her berries.
Yeah.
This was our exclusive Halloween design for one of our boxes. And now it's released to everyone. It's All Hallows Eve. I love this. I've done the berry. I got this started. I gotta get back to it. I won't get back to it. I want it finished this year.
Somebody finished it, huh?
A lot of people finished it.
Yeah.
All right, now we have Bark Berry Plus. So you get two pillows and a berry. And one of our friends made Ronnie the little bark
pillow of that. From my birthday, yeah. One birthday.
Now this one has the little paw prints on this little pillow is over one. So that's that. And I think, yeah, there's some over one on the berry too. But it's super cute. Bark berry. And then we have Be Like a Crow. So you've got the piece here, and then you got the berry. Be Like a Crow. Oh, wait, and I think these other ones are in here too. Yes. These other ones are in there as well. So basically, you're going to be doing a whole dough bowl of one book.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. That's fun. All right, and then we got Boardwalk Review. This is a little book and a berry. Needle book and a berry. Okay. Ooh. Oh, okay. I haven't done this one yet. Bristol Berries 2. Look at that. All in red. You like the red work? That's your pattern right there. And the thing is, the berries don't take a lot of time. They go by relatively quick. This is a new one that came out recently. This is Christmas Countdown. It's got the drum and the berry and then the solid piece there that you can use to count down to Christmas.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Do like a little counting pin maybe, or a little magnet somehow or the other. I don't remember this one. Come Back at Midnight. It's another bear. It's a berry and it's got a little tray there. You finish it as a tray, or you could frame it, or do it as a, is it stitched on the, oh my God, look at that. I didn't even see that. It has to be done as a tray, because it's got like, look, it's got like a fence on this edges there. Oh, wow. That's cool. And then you got to stitch it up like that?
Yeah. No, look at me. I am not stitching like that.
I stitch it. You have to sew it. All right, here's Charlotte's berries. This was from a sampler. And here's a companion piece. This is Charlotte's smalls. So it's more pieces from the sampler. Very cool. And then, chocolate or coffee?
Yeah, that was released last year, I'm thinking, in the market.
I think so. This is chocolate or coffee, and I say yes to both. Yeah. Mm, yummy, yummy, yummy. Okay. Oh, this is a sampler. This is Christy Byron. Byron. Ooh, look at this border. Cool. Look at that stuff.
Oh, Byron.
Look at all that. Wow, look at that border. That's pretty cool. So you got all the words at the top, you got all the business at the top, all the party in the bottom.
1832.
Wow. And then we have, oh, a Christmas blessing. Okay, so she's got the Christmas blessing, that's it on the large version, and then she has the little bitty one. If you can still find the gauze, I don't think it's available anymore, but there's the 40 count gauze. You do 1/1 stitching on gauze, but she quit providing the gauze in the book because she wasn't able to get it anymore. I'm not sure if it came back yet. Magic, this is Christmas magic moments, memory, magic. Oh, that's, I like it because it's not like traditional Christmas colors. It's kind of fun. And these remind me of like those old time ornaments that had those, that kind of pop in. It was 1950s style ornaments, I think.
Hmm. This remind me of the Mexican flag, the ornament in the center of it caught my attention.
Yeah, it does look like that. I just noticed that.
Yeah.
Little bit, yeah, interesting. Yeah, all right, and now we have the Christmas motif sampler. There's that right there, and then it also has the three little pieces stitch in addition to that. Okay, wow, That goes with the bark berry. That's in, we have to put that back in the bark berry.
Oh man.
Set that aside. Put it right there aside. All right, and this is Do Unto Others.
Okay, be careful with the bag because it has some charms.
Oh, okay. Do Unto Others. Look at that. That's a happy little cat. It's just laying there all like, I don't care how I look. I'm just gonna lay here. The butterfly. All right, and now we have a whole bunch of the Carolyn Berry series. This is Deck the Halls. So you can stitch the pattern as the little pillow or as the berry. I have the collection and I keep going back and forth, doing with the berries, doing with the pillows, because I like both. And then here we go. This is the English berries. English berries, look at that. That's fun. Mm-hmm. And then I'm gonna show these two together because we have all the seasons. We have summer and spring and winter and autumn. So it's just one color each that you just do that. It's so cool. You could put them all four together and stitch them all four together, maybe. No, because you need the darker fabrics for the darker months. Darn. Okay, that was crazy. Well, this one has something. This has a little letter button and a charm.
It's a heart
and a letter.
Letter. Okay. Yeah.
This is Forever Thine.
Right there.
Yeah. I like that one.
The square is the little letter and the little heart. Mm-hmm. Middle heart.
Yep.
It's a button.
Because see here, the little metal heart goes on the top there, next on the side of the berry, where the rose is. I like how she finishes the top of her berries. And here we have the fall bounty berry, and it's stitched on gingham. So there's that one. That's cool. I gotta see something. Okay. Oh, sorry, just me. All right, now we have Goodwill to Men. This is fun because you only use one color. Look at that. Yeah, the frame piece and then the berry.
Ah, beautiful.
Yeah, it is. It's stitched with Fathom. It's a dark blue from Weeks That Works.
To me.
Here is Hark the Bells.
And this one has little charms.
Oh, it's charms?
Ooh. A little star and
a little heart.
A heart button.
Okay. They must go on. The star goes on top of the tree and the heart goes
somewhere.
Oh, there, right there on the bottom. So the heart goes there and the star goes on top of the little tree over here.
Yeah.
Cool. And then we have Happy Hanukkah.
And these have six buttons.
Where do they go?
There.
Oh, they go in the pillow. Oh,
with that little
hook there for the pillow.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cute. I love the colors.
Yeah, I found out today when I pulled it out. Oh, this one has charms.
Mm-hmm. And then we have the heirloom tomato. Prosperity and good fortune. That's what the tomato means?
I'm thinking I'm putting the two heirlooms together. It's two different.
Okay.
This one has buttons.
Yeah, this has buttons.
Yeah, and they're probably behind that one.
Hmm. What?
Yeah, oh. That is the next.
Okay.
But so, we'll put it together.
We don't need to show that one again. So good, we had to look at it twice. Same one.
Oh, I'm thinking we're different.
No.
Oops.
Here we go. This is Heartside Christmas. Friends for your fireside, a wreath for your door, more pleasure at Christmas than ever before, contentment and laughter, good times and good cheer, peace to go with you all through the year, New Year. That's cute.
I like that.
Yeah. And then there's a little pillow, also. Smaller version. Cool. Oh, I stitched one of these. I still got to stitch the second one. I realized after I stitched it and I was going through my stuff, I stitched it. Oh, no, I didn't. Never mind. I thought I stitched it wrong, but both designs, you stitch it on the petty point, which is it's got the little white painted dots on it. So I did the little house. I still have to do this one right here. Holly Home Berries. Ooh, I did this one. This is the Honeyberry. This guy was so much fun. The Honeyberry. Look at that. So cute. I did them on that honeycomb fabric. This one is stitched on gauze. There's no gauze in here. Oh, wow. Okay, so we do have the gauze for this one. This is what the gauze is. This is 40 count gauze. You stitch everything, every hole with one thread, not a full X. You put a half stitch.
Wow.
So you stitch the whole thing. And this is, so it's like a little charm.
Oh my.
Or you could stitch it on fabric. And it'll be a little bit bigger pin pillow, which is what I'm going to do. I mean, gauze is easiest to stitch because you can see it. But the thing is, you got to fill up the whole piece. You got to do all the background and everything. This is more of that. This is Let It Snow.
Charms.
So you got charms for the pillow, charms for the berry.
Snowflakes and a heart.
Yep. The big snowflake goes on the top of the berry right here. So it's kind of cool. Okay. Letting go. Autumn shows us how beautiful it is to let things go. Drop that leaf. I just made that up, drop the leaf. That's cool.
And that is the charms. Button, a charm, and a heart.
Yeah, let's get that on the was it on the bias or whatever? When the stitching is pretty cool. Oh, another button. Life is better. Life is better. Woof. Isn't he cute? This is a fun little pattern. This is fun. Okay. Lions, tigers, and trims. Oh my. Oh, okay. So this is the outside. And so you're making some type of little roll thing. You do all that stuff on the inside and you roll it up and put your stuff inside of it. Your scissors and needles and stuff.
And thread. What is it? Thread?
Yeah, you hang your threads on there. So it's like a little project roll thing you like. Mermaid Crossing. Oh, this one was really popular at Stitching in the Wild. Mermaid Crossing. The berry. There's a little circle thing. There's the berry. And then here is the other piece right here. So I guess you could use that. That's a roll. That's that little rolled up thing right there that you can't really make out. But this is what it looks like.
I'm going to do it as a roll because you cannot appreciate it. It's an idea, but
no. I like to see what I stitch.
Yeah. I bet everybody love to see what they stitch. Enjoy it.
That's why we put glasses on so we can see what we stitch. This is naughty or nice. I need one, you need one. Naughty?
No.
Naughty and naughty?
I can't say it.
Naughty and nice. I like that one. Okay.
And the nice one. No, I'm the naughty.
He doesn't even know what he is. All right, this is from the Carolyn Berry series. This is O Tannenbaum. Is that O Tannenbaum? And then we still have quite a bit of patterns to go. Yeah. This is Peacock Party Berry. Ooh, I haven't done this one yet. Look at that.
Ooh, look at that.
Look
cute.
At the peacocks. Where's my peacock ladies at?
That had to be stitched in linen?
No, you can stitch it on Ada.
Oh, and Ada too?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I've seen Barry stitched on Ada.
That peacock's so cute. Yeah.
Especially well, on your 18 count Ada, that's like a 36 linen, so it'd be small.
Yeah.
Pumpkins, please. Look at that. So you make it like a little pillow, and then what they did is they put a little pocket in the back of the pillow to put your scissors in there. Well, the finisher did that, but pumpkins, please. Autumn's leaves and pumpkin, please. Oh, this is one that I got in touch with her. I thought this was a new pattern, but it's actually been out for a while. So this has got a couple of patterns. It's got the little gauze thing in there, but there's no gauze. There's a pumpkin, just a big pumpkin thing right there. And then there's the saying. And then there's a little one for 40 count gauze. This is pumpkins. Pumpkins at morning, pumpkins at noon. If it weren't for pumpkins, we should be undone. Undone. I don't know what that means. But anyway, I like it anyway. It's so cool. The colors just drive me in. And here is Quaker Wisdom Berries. I've done these. Quaker Wisdom Berries. I may not have wisdom, but I've got berries that's wise.
Okay, now you can go with the other one. It's on
yeah.
The side.
Yeah, I know. I got to do part one.
Okay.
So this is ABCs, Quilting ABCs. It was a five-part series. Now it's all out. So here is part one. So you get the first part of the alphabet. And then you would also get another pattern to stitch. But eventually you would get the whole piece. So here's part one, here's part two is F through K in the alphabet. So each little quilt is like a little quilt pattern. Then here's a little piece back there. And then here's part five, so you can see what the whole thing looks like, but it's got, this is what the whole thing looks like when it's stitched, part five. So it's got all the alphabet and the alphabet words are...
We're missing 3 and 4.
Yeah, but we can get them. So you...
I mean, we are out of the 3 and 4.
I finished this one, but I still got to do the berry and the drum. This is the reindeer games. It's hanging up. It's in the bedroom.
Oh, it's Christmas.
Yeah, it's Christmas. It's on its way to the shop when the shop is done. I don't like that one. So I did finish one of them.
Yeah.
This is Sally Bullard. And we have a thread pack for her. Sally Bullard, she's stitched with Gentle Arts wool threads. So we have the wool thread pack for her. Okay. We have a sampler berry. So it's 2 berries in this pack. Okay. And then we have Scary Berry. So when Erica Michaels was able, when Linda was able to get gauze, she always would have 2 patterns. One pattern would be the gauze, and one pattern would be for the linen berry. And she would say linen berry or the gauze berry. But then around the pandemic, she couldn't get the gauze anymore. So then she started putting the patterns together. So you'll start seeing some of the patterns have both berries in the pattern. So you could stitch it on, you could still, if you could get the silk gauze, you could still stitch it on silk gauze, or you could stitch both of them on linen. And this one would not be that small if you did it on linen. It would probably, it'd be bigger, but it's 2 different types of two different patterns, which is what, why I still liked it.
Mm-hmm. And she had in every chart how to cut the berries.
Yeah, the template.
Yeah, the template. Yeah. I can never remember that word.
Template. Here is St. Nick's berry. So I did the bigger berry. I haven't done the small one yet. Look at these small ones. They're so cute. So what you could do, you could probably, since if you did the bigger berry on, say, on your normal 32, you could probably do the smaller berry on a 40 count linen. And that way you would still, you'd have the 2 sizes. Or maybe a little bit bigger. I don't know. I just thought about stitching on 40 count linen all of a sudden. Like, oh, no. I did this one. This is Stitch All the Things. Stitch All the Things. It's what we were doing during the pandemic. We stitched everything we could get our hands on.
And have 4 buttons.
Yeah. I did the pillow. I still got to do the berry. And then we have summertime berries. Oh, it's got a flamingo. Look at that little flamingo berry.
Mm-hmm.
And the word summer.
I was looking for the flamingo.
Flamingo. And there's a little trailer, a little summer. Okay, so I did the sunshine berry, but I did the bigger one. So I did this one right here, the sunshine berry. And now you can do both in the pattern. Here's the Freedom Berry.
Ooh.
Yeah, so you got both patterns in this book, this Freedom Berry. I did the big one. I have it in the table.
Okay.
So you can do the small one on 40 count.
No.
Here's the... Sweetheart berry. This is what it, how it used to be. She would say it's the linen berry. So this was, is just the linen berry pattern.
It's one of the older ones.
Yeah. And here is...
Your chair is squeaking.
I know, it's squeaking. I'm trying not to move. The more you try not to move, here is a duplicate.
Oh, man.
All right, this is Stingy Jack and Friends. So you get some crazy fabric, color fabrics, and you just stitch the face. So you just stitch the eyes, the nose, and then you turn them into type of drum things like that. I'm excited to do that one.
That's so cute.
Yeah, because you don't have to stitch anything but the face.
And it's look easy to finish it. You mm-hmm. can finish it yourself.
Yeah, yep, you can finish it for me.
I said you can finish yourself.
I didn't hear that. I need to start this one. I haven't started this one. This is The Beach Is Calling. This came out last year.
Cool. Beach Is Calling. I love that.
It's got the, there's a trolley.
I don't know who is more in trouble, you guys or this guy, because he goes stitch everything.
I think I'm in trouble. But I'm having flashbacks because a lot of these things are in my stash. I remember pulling them out and showing him.
I mean, it's so cute.
Yeah, this is the sewing bee. So I've done one. I've done one bee drawing.
Two buttons and scissors.
Yeah.
Do I can see it? I can.
Scissors are here.
I'm sorry. No, I was there.
Mm. All right. So the scissors is hanging here. Little hearts right there. Oh, the heart's over here. The scissors are over here. All right. So you've got one bee. I've done one bee pattern, and now I need to stitch the other bee pattern to go. So I'm bee berries. All right. This is the embroideress. And this was it was under a different name when it first came out as an exclusive, but then when she released it for everybody, it's called the embroideress. We have one finishing kit left.
Wow.
So if, you know, so with all the accoutrements, thingies, stuff.
That is the class angle?
Yep.
Yeah.
And here we go from the Carolyn Berry series. This is Fidelis.
Yeah. I don't know what that means.
German?
No, it's not German.
No. This is Deck the Halls. I can say that one. Deck the Halls. And what she's done when we're in her room and she has all of the Carolyn Berries together, she has them all with the outside facing out and they're all in a circle, so it looks like a pie.
Mm.
Now what pie? This is
Joy to the World. I like that.
You know what? I think my compromise will be to do the berries but in green. Because I like this look and I like that idea of the berry, and then I just keep going back. What do I want to do? So now the more I'm looking at these, I think I'll do all my berries in green. Okay. Star of Wonder from the Carolyn Berry series. Star of Wonder. Got the camels there. And the star and the music notes. And then we're getting there. We're getting close. We're under Erica Michaels.
Yes.
This is The Moon Is Full. Beware. Halloween is in the air. The moon is full. Beware. You hear that? Now this face on this, the face on the moon. Look at that face with the bats. That is so cool. And then we have a salty mermaid. Mermaids welcome. Sea hag. Sea hag is a noun. A mermaid before she has had her coffee. Hmm. Interesting. So there's all the goodies you get to stitch and do that. Yeah, when we had the trunk show, we had those all laying out.
Yeah.
Super fun. And here is the sampler book. This is all the patterns for the sampler, right? Is this the patterns? I don't know. She's got a website link in the book to get, I think, all the specialty stitched patterns. This is the instructions, I think. I'm not sure how she had it broken out for the cover and stuff. All right. Ooh, this is one that can be done on gauze. But you can also do it. I would also do this on regular fabric. It'd be a little bit bigger. This is Thanksgiving bits. So my mine wouldn't be a bit, it would be a Thanksgiving. Because it would not be little.
Mm-hmm.
This is tiptoe, ooh, got a bunch of buttons there. Yep. Tiptoe through the tulips, just in time for tulip season. Look at that. I love the berry.
The candy, no. Huh? No, never mind.
No, they're just little buttons.
And see if they...
Yeah, they're little buttons that go across the top here, so you don't have to stitch. They go across the top of that pillow, so you don't have to stitch them. Pretty smart. And now we have
more buttons. More buttons.
Turkey time. Oh, look at that gobble gobble. I could probably stitch berries for a whole year. This is Twinkle Twinkle.
Twinkle Twinkle.
Oh, I love this. So here she's done it in the blue for like a baby boy. But then if you have a baby girl, you could do Twinkle Twinkle in the pinks.
Mm-hmm.
Or if you have a baby Gary, you could do the Twinkle Twinkle in green.
Well, I'm glad you know how little Gary.
Oh, okay. All right, so this is Wicked
Buttons.
Wicked Cute. So this is from her button-up series. So I've stitched the berry, but then the little piece here you stitch. She gives you the card that you would finish your piece on. So it's not really thick, but I mean, it's small enough you just attach that on there. I don't know how you do it.
Oh,
so cool.
Instance, mm-hmm. Probably glue it.
Yeah, I don't know.
Or sewing it. I don't know.
I don't know. I would definitely stick. I would probably put that cardboard attached to a stiffer cardboard. That way, I don't know. It'd be a little bit sturdier. Because knowing me, I would damage it after I packed it up somewhere. This is winter berries. So there's the word winter, and then you got the two winter themed berries. So she did spring, summer, winter. Autumn. This is a fun one. This was so easy because there's like nothing to stitch on it. The yipes berry.
Yeah.
It's just the word yipes and the big spider. Look at that. Okay, and now the last one from Erica Michaels is Vintage Garden Smalls. So you got a little needle book, a berry, and a little tray that you would stitch. Isn't that cute? Super cute.
Here is my work forever stand. The labor of two busy hands.
Yep.
The labor of two busy hands.
Yep.
I love that.
Oh yeah.
This is so cute.
It's got flowers on there, so of course
you can. And the say is beautiful.
Yeah.
Yep.
All right, so now.
Now we go with Erin.
We have.
And there's Erin.
Erin Elizabeth Designs.
Yep.
We have a few from her. I think this goes with that. This is the Halloween tier. You know, I grabbed this one because he has the Frankenstein. I have my Frankenstein collection. So I can stitch berries and Frankensteins probably for the rest of my life. Oh, I didn't get this one. Pick your poison. Yes, look at that. Oh my gosh. I love the candy corn martini thingy, whatever that is. Oh, it's not hard to stitch. Sorry. I may start that soon. Pick your poison.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Summer tier. See, now you know why it took me 3 hours to do my
My stash died when Ronnie wasn't here. I was distracted a lot. Summer tear. And then the last one for today is winter tear.
Oh, I don't know how this one coming
in. Yeah, this is winter tear. So we get a little nutcracker on the top. And we've got some black Lugana, gray charcoal Lugana that this would look nice on. If I'm gonna do black, I'll do Lugana because it's easier to see. So that.
And y'all, that is all for.
That's all of the D's and E's.
D's and E's.
That we have in the shop. And if it's patterns that we've shown, just rewind, stop, slow it down. The name is there on the chart. You can always, when you click on the website, it'll be there, a section called categories. Under categories, it'll be cross stitch. Click on the cross stitch, and then you'll see the images of all the designers' logos, if they have logos. Click on their name. It'll open up everything they have in their currently that we have in stock for them on the website, and they're all alphabetical.
Yeah.
So have fun. This has been a nice long
video. We hope you enjoying
yes
this video, and thank you for accompanying us and the shop. And thank you so much for all the comments. I'm really appreciating. We enjoying doing this for you guys. Mm-hmm.
And again, we will put at the drop down under the document section there, we'll put down
what video
number and what letter is in those video numbers and the name of the video. So that way you can always go back, reference it, and it'll always be in the drop down.
Yeah. That is it.
That's it.
And then see you next week, y'all.
Bye, everyone.